Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us talk about Exemestane. Exemestane is one of the drugs which is classified as aromatase inhibitor. And particularly, Exemestane is an irreversible inhibitor of this enzyme aromatase. And this drug is used in the treatment of postmenopausal breast cancer. But this drug is not indicated for the treatment of breast cancer in premenopausal women, because aromatase enzyme is more significant in postmenopausal women compared with the premenopausal women. That's why it is not indicated for the treatment of breast cancer in premenopausal women. And this Exemestane is one of the steroidal drug. Because of its steroidal structure, this drug can strongly bind to this enzyme aromatase. That's why it acts as irreversible enzyme inhibitor. So today in this video, we are going to see how this drug acts, what are the important precautions, side effects, doses, all these things we will discuss in this video. Now let us see how this drug acts. In the premenopausal woman, ovary acts as an important source for production of estrogens. From the ovary, estrogens like estradiol can be produced, which can be converted into estrone. But in the postmenopausal woman, estrogens are not produced from the ovary. Because of menopause, they are going to be derived from the androgens. So testosterone is one of the important sources, and androne is the androstenedione. This testosterone can be converted into estradiol, and androstenedione can be converted into estrone. Both of these conversions are mediated by one of the enzyme, aromatase. That's why Exemestane blocks this enzyme, thereby it inhibits the synthesis of estrogens from androgens. So this synthesis takes in the peripheral tissues, which increase the synthesis of estrogens. So circulatory estrogen levels are increased by the activity of aromatase enzyme. So androstenedione and testosterone are the important source for estrogen synthesis in the postmenopausal woman. And this conversion is mediated by the enzyme aromatase. So here, androstenedione can be converted into estrone and testosterone can be converted into estradiol. This estrone can be converted into estradiol. So the final mediator is the estradiol, which can act on the peripheral tissues, which are responsive to the estrogen. For instance, in the breast tissue, estrogen receptors are located within the cytoplasm, where they are coupled with estrogen responsive elements. Now, estradiol can bind to these estrogen receptors, which is going to be dimerized and internalized within the nucleus to interact with the DNA. This produces the estrogen response, resulting in the proliferation of the breast tissue, leading to increased progression of breast cancer. Exemestane is a steroidal aromatase inhibitor. Because of its steroidal structure, it can easily bind to this aromatase enzyme, thereby it can inhibit the activity of this enzyme. When this enzyme is inhibited, androstenedione and testosterone cannot be converted into estrogens. So this results in the decreased synthesis of estrogens in postmenopausal women. When these estrogen levels are reduced, the activation of estrogen receptors is going to be reduced. So this results in the decreased proliferation and progression of breast cancer. In this way, Exemestane can be used for the treatment of breast cancer in postmenopausal women. Now let us see the precautions of this drug. One of the important precautions of Exemestane is that this drug can reduce the bone mineral density, so it can increase the risk of osteoporosis. Particularly, this effect can also be observed with another drug, tamoxifen, which is a estrogen receptor antagonist. Since in the breast cancer, initially tamoxifen can be used, followed by Exemestane. So both of these drugs can reduce the bone mineral density. So in such patients, this drug should be carefully given. And the reduction of bone mineral density is more pronounced on prolonged treatment. So when this Exemestane is used for greater than 1 year, the bone mineral density is going to be reduced. Similarly, in the early stage of breast cancer, women may have some deficiency of vitamins. Particularly, the 25-hydroxy vitamin deficiency can be observed in the women with early stage of breast cancer. In such patients, exemestane should be carefully given. So before the treatment with exemestane, vitamin D level should be checked. And during the treatment, vitamin D supplementation can be given in order to reduce the deficiency observed in the early stage of breast cancer. This supplementation is more important as exemestane reduces the bone mineral density. So if a woman is already having low vitamin D levels, it further increases the risk of bone fractures and osteoporosis. Similarly, exemestane can produce some fetal toxicity. So in the pregnant woman, this drug should not be used, as it produces some harmfulness to the fetus. What are the side effects? The important side effect of exemestane is the hot flushes. So women can experience some hot sensation with redness of the skin, particularly at the face, neck and arms, which is commonly observed with many of the hormone responsive drugs. Similarly, other side effects mainly include fatigue, arthralgia, joint pain, headache, insomnia, lack of sleep, and excessive sweating can be observed with this exemestane. Now let us see the chemical nature of this drug. So this is the structure of exemestane. We can see that it is having the steroidal nucleus. So this structure is having the androstane nucleus with two double bonds. So we can write this as androstar-1,4-diene. And we can also observe two ketone groups at 3rd position and 17th position. So 3,17-dione. And a methylene group is attached at the 6th position. So 6-methylene. That is the complete name of exemestane. How it is given? This drug is given as a tablet form at a strength of 25 mg. And this drug is given at a dose of 25 mg as once daily after meal. For early stage of breast cancer, this drug can be used as adjuvant after tamoxifen therapy up to 5 years. But for the advanced stage of breast cancer, this drug can be used for treatment after tamoxifen therapy. So that's about this drug, exemestane, which is a steroidal aromatase inhibitor. Because of steroidal structure, it can produce irreversible inhibition of this enzyme. And this drug is indicated for the treatment of breast cancer in postmenopausal women. Hot flushes, arthralgia and fatigue are the important side effects produced by this drug. And when this drug is prescribed for longer periods, the bone mineral density may be reduced and vitamin D supplementation may be required in those patients with any deficiency of vitamin D. So that's about this drug, exemestane. That's for today. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.